That's part 151 of Ghost of Tsushima.
You butchered them. Is Yarikawa giving us trouble again?
The Yarikawa rebellion was 20 years ago. Those men were with the Mongols.
Of course. Seeing you like that, I'm still shaken up. I need to catch my breath.
By the lake. Your favorite tree.
Yes. Come.
You said earlier you've been making poisons.
Keeps the vermin out of our rice.
Can you make it stronger? Enough to kill a man?
No one deserves that.
Can you do it?
The effects in larger doses are ugly.
Good.
Oh, my lord. Sit with me a moment. Poison has never been the Sakai way.
No Sakai had to fight the Mongol Empire. I need every weapon we have. Tsushima can't afford anything less.
The Mongols have changed you, young master.
The world has changed.
About plants that heal, others that harm, even kill. But they must be consumed. How will you poison the invaders?
Blowgun and darts. I've read of their use by a Genji warrior who studied with monks from the west. Will you help me?
Promise me you'll remain the good man I know.
I promise.
After your every need since your mother carried you. I won't stop now.
All I need is something to make a blowgun.
Used to be a lot of reeds on the other side of the lake, where the old fishermen lived. Remember, you and your little friend gathered them to make little boats.
Yuzo and I, we spent all day reenacting the Battle of Dunnola.
Be careful, Jim. I've seen fires over there at night. Not sure who it is.
Don't worry. I'll be back soon with reeds.
Go get your reeds.
I was right. The old fisherman's home has been taken over by bandits. Hey!
That was almost friendly to me. Triple now. Reads.
Perfect for a blowgun. I'll get these to Yuriko.
caught me thinking about Lord Sakai.
I try not to do that.
He loved you in his way.
Enough of the past. We have a blowgun and darts. All I need now is the poison.
Of course, young master. Come. I have a small camp where we gather plants and herbs for ointments. And poison. It kills vermin within moments.
Make it strong enough for the invaders.
Yes.
You and Lord Shimura taught me to ride. On that runt pony.
You sat so tall and straight in your little saddle. You were the shogun himself.
Shit. Why did I do that? Get on the horse.
So funny.
I just remembered it was out here you nearly killed your uncle.
What?
You were 3 or 4. The poor man was trying to teach you how to hold your wooden kodachi. You wanted to chase butterflies.
I know the story. My uncle's black eye took weeks to heal.
Lord Shimura and your father laughed so hard, I fear they both choked to him.
I don't remember my father's laugh.
He lost his humor after your mother got sick. But you have your father's laugh. Here we are.
Akosa met in a campfire. You sleep out here?
Only when I spend the day foraging for plants. I look for the flowers we need.
Rest, Yuriko. I will get them for you.
Don't eat the seeds, they're poisonous.
Another child,
Donna.
Here you go.
Oh, I know. Remember how we gather flowers for your mother?
She arranged them for the little alcove at home.
That should be enough. Bring them to me, young master.
Your plants?
Good. We extract the seeds, crush them, make a paste, and dip the needles.
Make sure the dose is strong.
It should do what you need. It's done.
You're sure you came this way? The old woman has a camp around here somewhere.
God damn it.
Someone's coming.
Thank you for watching part 151. I'll see you in part 152. Let's test the poison.
If this poison works.